So we start with lecture number 6, children. Just that you should know, we have completed each and every sum of this chapter. Anyways, if I have missed any sum, just let me know by the next lecture. As of now, the pending part for this particular chapter is theorems. Now, there are certain theorems which are important and which we will be discussing today, as well as the next lecture, right? So two lectures, the chapter would be done completely along with theorems. Now, as soon as I use this term theorem in a general way, like from the first chapter itself, I hope you all remember those 6 particular steps. Now, those 6 particular steps, children, were, the first step was the statement itself. Second step was to draw the figure. Third step was to write down the given. Fourth was to prove. Fifth, construction if needed. And at the end was proof, right? The 6 steps. So we start with the very first step for this particular theorem. The name is interior angles test. So here is the statement, children. The first step is done. Now we need to draw the figure. In order to do that, we need to understand the statement. It says, interior angles formed by a transversal of 2 distinct lines are supplemented. Now the word distinct means different. So there are 2 different lines, and it is not mentioned whether they are parallel or not, right? But something else is mentioned. What is that? Interior angles formed by the transversal are supplementary. Imagine kar rahe do random lines and a transversal. Now, there is a pair of interior angles formed. Now, it depends upon you. Ki aap log kaun sa pair select karte ho. For instance, I have selected these 2 pairs here in the figure, right? You could have also selected this. So, ye dono interior angles, and it is given that interior angles are supplementary. So, angle BPQ, angle BPQ plus angle PQD is equals to 180. This is what is given, right? To prove kya hai? Then the 2 lines are parallel. Matlab humko proof karna hai ki segment AB or line AB is parallel to line C. I hope this much is clear to all of you. So we have dealt with how many steps here? The first step was the statement itself. The second step, figure, which is already done. Third, given, already done. Fourth, to prove, done. The fifth was construction, which we don't need here, right? And the last step, children, was proof, right? So we start with proof. Now here is a very special proof. Now why special proof? Because this, or in fact, there are very few theorems like this where we deal with those theorems in a very different way. The name of that different way, children, is indirect method. Now, what is this indirect method? Indirect method wo hota hai jahan pe we start with an assumption which is exactly opposite of what is to be proved. Jaise yahan pe proof kya kar raha hai? AB parallel to CD. तो उसका उल्टा क्या होगा? AB not parallel to CD. So this is how we'll start our sum or the theorem. Like I would state, let us assume that line AB is not parallel to line CD. I hope this much is clear to all of you. राइट अब इनडायरेक्ट मेथड में एग्जैक्टली करने क्या वाले हैं मैं आपको एक एग्जांपल देके समझाता हूँ. फॉर इंस्टेंस देयर इज अ चाइल्ड चिल्ड्रन. अब छोटे बच्चे लोग क्या करते हैं? फॉर इंस्टेंस पेरेंट्स उनको बोलेंगे कि चाइल्ड डोंट पुट योर फिंगर इनसाइड अ सॉकेट. जो अपना घर पे रहता है ना इलेक्ट्रिक बोर्ड पे एक सॉकेट, वहां पे आपको पेरेंट्स बोलेंगे कि वहां पे अंदर फिंगर इंसर्ट मत करो. बट वो बच्चा करता है कि ऐसा नहीं, द चाइल्ड डज इट. तो करने के बाद वो बच्चे को क्या रियलाइजेशन होता है? अरे मेरे को शॉक लगा. सो द सेम थिंग विल बी डीलिंग विद योर. मतलब समझाता हूं, बच्चे का बिलीफ एग्जैक्टली उल्टा था किससे जो उसके पेरेंट्स ने बोला. पेरेंट्स ने बोला मत यू गेट अ शॉक, बट बच्चे ने बिलीव नहीं किया. बच्चे का क्या बिलीव था कि मुझे शॉक नहीं लगेगा, उसने फिंगर इंसर्ट किया. और क्योंकि उसका बिलीव अजम्पशन रॉन्ग था उसको बाद में पता चला, हेंस प्रूफ. वैसा ही कुछ यहाँ पे भी होने वाला है. डोंट वरी, अगर नहीं समझा तो फॉरगेट अबाउट द एग्जांपल, जस्ट फोकस ऑन व्हाट वी हैव डन टिल नाउ. आई होप एवरीबॉडी हैज एटलीस्ट अंडरस्टूड व्हाटएवर इज देयर ऑन द स्क्रीन, राइट? सो वी मूव अहेड. इट चिल्ड्रन, एक चीज सिंपल सा क्वेश्चन है. लाइन ए बी और लाइन सी डी, लाइन ए बी और लाइन सी डी अगर पैरेलल नहीं है, विल दे इंटरसेक्ट? यस. सो एज पर आवर अजम्पशन एक और फिगर आना चाहिए. अब मैंने दूसरा फिगर यहाँ पे नीचे ड्रॉ नहीं किया, यहीं पे ड्रॉ कर रहा हूँ. आपको दोनों फिगर ड्रॉ करने पड़ेंगे एग्जाम्स में. एक जो स्टेटमेंट से ड्रॉ होता है जो आपको अभी दिख रहा है स्क्रीन पे, दूसरा जो अजम्पशन के बेसिस पे बनता है, राइट? सो देयर विल बी टू फिगर्स फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर थ्योरम. द सेकेंड फिगर हैज टू बी समथिंग लाइक दिस. तो हमने ऊपर वाला जो लाइन था उसको टिल्ट कर दिया है, अब नीचे वाले लाइन को टिल्ट करेंगे. सो बेसिकली दे इंटरसेक्ट एट अ सिंगल पॉइंट, और वो पॉइंट को मैं एक नेम देने वाला हूँ. नाउ डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज, क्योंकि तीन अल्फाबेट एक साथ में दिखने वाले. दिस लाइन इज ए बी एंड दिस लाइन इज सी डी, और ये जो पॉइंट है इसको हमने नाम दिया है टी, राइट? नाउ चिल्ड्रन, आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर ट्राइंगल, ट्राइंगल पी क्यू बी जो आप लोग फिगर में देख पा रहे हैं. चिल्ड्रन, इन दिस ट्राइंगल कैन आई अप्लाई एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी? एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी मतलब तीनों एंगल्स का एडिशन इज इक्वल टू 180. सो एंगल पी क्यू टी और टी पी क्यू, व्हाटएवर इट इज, एंगल टी पी क्यू प्लस एंगल पी क्यू टी प्लस एंगल पी टी क्यू इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अ ट्राइंगल. Now children, ये जो TPQ है, TPQ, if you look at it in the figure, TPQ को can I write it as can I write it as BPQ? TPQ को can I write it as BPQ? Isn't it the same? Yes. Why? Because of betweenness. If you all remember from the first chapter, B dash A dash B, तीनों एक ही line पे. So TPQ को हमने लिखा PPQ plus. Now this PQT, can I write it as PQD? ये जो PQT angle है, can I write it as PQD? Again the reason has to be between this Q dash T dash D. The third angle I'll write it as it is. अब question ये कि sir ये किया क्यों? Because if you look at the given children, मेरे पास यहाँ पर एंगल P था, यहाँ पर भी P है, Q है, Q है, but the names of the angles were different. So just to make them similar or match with the given information, मैंने उनको convert किया. I hope this much is clear. Yeah. Now I'll just copy whatever is given to us. So हम लोगों को given क्या है? Angle BPQ plus angle PQD is equals to 180. ये children, दोनों equations जो है, equation one and equation two, दोनों का right hand side देखना जरा. What are the right hand sides of each of the equations? 180, and both of them are equal. Now since the right hand sides are equal, what can we state about the left hand sides? They too are equal. So यहाँ पे left hand side में ये तीन terms हैं, यहाँ पर left hand side में ये दो terms. So BQD plus PQD plus PPQ is equal to BPQ plus PQD. Now if you look, there are similar terms on either side, जो कि cancel होने वाले. जैसे यहाँ पे BPQ और BPQ will get cancelled, PQD PQD will get cancelled. So what is left? Left hand side पे PTQ, right hand side पे कुछ बचा है? Nothing is left. So what is left is zero. So angle PTQ is equal to 0 degree. अच्छा, ये जो answer अभी तक हमको मिला है, मेक इट वेरी क्लियर कि ये अजम्पशन के बेसिस पे मिला है, राइट? तो अगर हम बोलते हैं कि दोनों लाइन पैरेलल नहीं है, तब जाके एंगल पीटीक्यू 0 डिग्री होता है. और एक एंगल 0 डिग्री होता है, उसका मीनिंग पता है आपको? The meaning is very simple. An angle can only be zero when both the lines are same. कौन सा दोनों line AB and CB दोनों same line होंगे. But यहाँ पे तो हमको clearly दिख रहा है दो अलग अलग line. Question में भी statement में भी लिखा है two distinct lines, right? So that means अभी मैं लिखने वाला हूँ कि zero degree का meaning क्या होता है. What is the meaning of the word zero degree? Zero degree means line AB and line CB are not two different lines. ये assumption के हिसाब से आया. लेकिन given क्या है? Clearly but this contradicts the given. Contradicts मतलब given के खिलाफ जा रहा है. तो हमारा assumption जो है वो given के खिलाफ है. And hence we state that our assumption is wrong. और क्योंकि हमने बोला कि हमारा assumption wrong है. हमारा assumption क्या था कि दोनों parallel नहीं है. अगर वो wrong है तो right क्या होना चाहिए? दोनों line parallel. I hope it is clear. Now don't worry. In our entire syllabus, there is only one indirect which we have already discussed. There are very few schools who asked this in their exams. Though I want you all to copy this and draw two figures for the same thing, right? The first figure is to be drawn, which you can see right now on the screen. The second figure, जो बीच में मैंने दिखाया था assumption, right? Do one thing, leave space for the first figure. The first figure last minute. अभी के लिए कॉपी करो, पहले सेकंड फिगर ड्रॉ कर लेना. फर्स्ट फिगर के लिए ऊपर थोड़ा सा स्पेस छोड़ देना. ओके, जस्ट कॉपी. फॉर दोस किड्स हु हैव नॉट अंडरस्टूड सम पार्ट, यू कैन वॉच द वीडियो वंस अगेन फ्रॉम यूट्यूब. देन स्टिल इफ द डाउट प्रोसेस, यू मे जस्ट आस्क योर सेंटर हेड्स एंड देन वील डिस्कस, राइट? You can send your doubts. The first figure is to be drawn. इसके लिए आपको space छोड़ना है. I'll just show that second figure later. I mean the first figure later on. This is the second figure based on assumption. If you want, you can just write beneath the figure based on assumption. और वो वाले figure के नीचे आप लिख सकते हो based on the statement. I want you all to copy everything here. The statement given to group, figure, group, everything. This will come. If at all it is asked. There are very few schools who ask this. finished copying along with the figure. Moving ahead, children. I believe you might have finished it. I request you all to take a screenshot of it if you have not finished. In order to understand this theorem once again in detail, you can just go through the YouTube video lecture. Okay. I hope everybody has taken a screenshot at least if not finished copying. Yeah, so we move on to the next slide. I want you all to copy this now. And this is the first figure, as you can see it on the screen. You can just write your figure based on the statement. Beneath the figure, you can just write down figure based on the statement. Finished? Yeah, if not, you can just take a screenshot now, children. We move ahead. We talk about the next theorem. Now, if you all remember, there were three statements for this particular heading, like test. And there were three theorems, teen test or teen theorem. So, total six statements. So, out of those six statements, we have discussed one, which was based direct thought. Two are very direct and very easy, and these two are very frequently asked in it. Is if a pair of alternate angles formed by a transversal of two lines is congruent, then the two lines are parallel. So basically, from the statement, we first of all need to draw the figure. So we draw a figure where there are two alternate angles which is stated that they are congruent. So we select these two alternate angles. I hope everybody remembers alternate matlab Z shape. So A and B are equal, that is what is given to us. And we need to prove that line L is parallel to line M. Now there is a small thing, children, which I'll be needing here. And that thing right here, which I just shown it here. ये जो angle है इसको randomly कोई variable हमको allot करना है. I have allotted variable C. Tell me what is the relation between A and C? As you can see it in the figure, they form a linear pair, right? So we can state that angle A plus angle C is equals to 180 degree. Correct? बट चिल्ड्रन इफ यू लुक एट द गिवन पार्ट एंगल ए किसको इक्वल है बी दैट इज व्हाट इज गिवन ए किसको इक्वल है सो इंस्टेड ऑफ ए इन दिस इक्वेशन कैन वी राइट बी ए के बदले बी लिख सकते हैं क्या तो क्या हो जाएगा इक्वेशन बी प्लस सी इज इक्वल टू 180 नाउ इफ यू लुक एट द फिगर चिल्ड्रन बी एंड सी they form a pair of interior angles and kyunki humne interior angles test already prove kar diya hai to hum log usko directly use kar sakte hain matlab we can directly state that since pair of interior angles are supplementary therefore line l is parallel to line m interior angles test I hope it is clear मतलब अल्टरनेट एंगल टेस्ट एंड करस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल टेस्ट में हम लोग इंटीरियर एंगल टेस्ट को यूज कर सकते हैं डायरेक्टली क्यों क्योंकि हमने ऑलरेडी इंटीरियर एंगल टेस्ट को इनडायरेक्ट मेथड से प्रूव कर दिया अच्छा एग्जाम में अगर अल्टरनेट एंगल टेस्ट आता है तो सर ऐसा किया तो चलेगा क्या यस डेफिनेटली यू कैन डायरेक्टली यूज इंटीरियर एंगल टेस्ट आई होप इट इज क्लियर खाली एक इंटीरियर एंगल टेस्ट को आपको इनडायरेक्ट मेथड से प्रूव करना है बाकी दोनों डायरेक्ट मेथड जस्ट कॉपी दिस एंटायर थिंग अलोंग विद द फिगर Next copy. Finish copying. If not, children, I request you all to take a screenshot of it. Then we move ahead. Hope everybody has taken a screenshot, right? So we move ahead to the next and the last theorem for today, corresponding angles test. The statement, we all know it, if the corresponding angles are equal, then the lines are parallel. So we draw two corresponding angles, or in fact we consider two corresponding angles, and it is stated that those two corresponding angles are equal. We give random variables to this, A and B equal hai, aur humko prove karna hai ki lines parallel. Definitely we can use interior angles test, kyunki wo humne prove kar diya. Right? So line L is parallel to line M. Now children, A and B are equal. I consider a random third alphabet in the figure, which is C. अच्छा, ये दोनों adjacent angles है and there is a special relation between these two angles. That special relation is nothing but linear pair. So we state angle A plus angle C is equals to 180. Equation 1. Now look at the given part. Given part says A is equal to B. Now instead of A in the first equation, can I write it as B using the second equation? A ke badle hum log likhenge B. So the equation B plus C is equals to 180. Now if you look at the figure, children, B and C, they form an interior angle, right? Interior angle hai. So added together, they are supplementary. Therefore, the lines are parallel using interior angles test. I hope it is clear. Just copy this and we are done for the day. I'll give you a small homework. Once you have completed this, just copy this. Finish. Yeah, request you all to take a screenshot of this. You can just copy it from there. We'll be having a 15-20 minutes break, maybe 25 minutes, I don't know. Just take a screenshot of it. Yeah, I hope you have taken a screenshot. Now, I end the lecture here, children. But just a small thing here. This three theorems which we have studied today, the first one is important, not that important, but the second and third one, they are very frequently asked in the exams, right? So I want you all to practice these three theorems thoroughly two times as homework. Now this is given to you all as a practice part. Homework se zyada, this is given to you all as a practice part. I want you all to practice, make sure you all do that, right? Thank you so much, children. God bless you all. Sashikant sir, I'm done with my lecture.
Thank you so much, sir.